Good afternoon to class 6th. I hope with the introduction of exercise 11.4, which is about the coefficient, variables, constant, how you find the number of terms, right? Degree of the polynomials, type of the polynomials, about the coefficients. You understand the introduction of exercise 11.4, which I gave in the previous video. Clear, students? So today we are start our exercise, that is 11.4. In this exercise, so students, the first question of this exercise is identify the coefficient, variable and constant in terms of the following expression. So if you have watched the introduction, then you can tell easily that which one is coefficient, which one is variables and which one is constant. Now with one question, that is A part, 2x plus 3. In this question, what we have to tell, which one is coefficient, variable and constant. So this 3, this is constant. This 2, this is coefficients. And this x is variable. Right? Now, in this question, how you will do this? Firstly, you will write here term. Then coefficient, then variable and then constant, right? Now with this term, as I write here 2x plus 3, so in this coefficient is 2, variable x and constant 3. The B part, that is 4y square minus 5. In this, the coefficient is 4, variable is y square and constant is 5. So clear? The two part you will do yourself. Now come to the key 2. Find the number of the terms in the following expression and list each one of them. Now in this, what you have to do? We have to write number of terms, right, and the expressions. So what is the term? The single one. So in this, how many terms are there? 1, 2 and 3. And these are 3 terms. Write like this. 3 terms. A square, 2ab and bq. In the b part, how many terms? 2. 2a cube and 3b square. Right? Now come to c part. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 terms. And one more thing that is important is, if the given term is of negative sign, like this, so you will write it like this: 2x square minus xy, 6x and minus 4y, right? So it means you have to write the term with the sign. Now come to D part. In this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terms, and these are 2pq minus 3p square, 4p minus 5 and minus 6p4. In this, there is only one term. So clear, all of you, how to find the number of the terms in the given expression. Now key 3, write all the factors of the following terms. So what are the factors? factors are that divide the given polynomial completely. Right? So 2ab is divided by, it can be divided by 2 also and 2ab also. Clear? After that, this 4xy cube. So it can be divided by firstly with 4, then 4xy cube. And see, here is 4. 4 is divided by 2. So 2xy cube. Clear? This we have discussed in the video, that what is the meaning of the factors and how you find the factors. So those who have not watched the previous video, before started this exercise beta, watch the previous one. Now come to the C part, 2p, 4 and q. So simply, firstly we will divide with constant, that is 2, and then with the complete one, 2p power 4q. So clear how to find the factors. After this, the next one is K4, that is identify the like terms in the following expression. So what are the like terms? The terms which are having the same base and same power, like this x square and x square, right? Don't look at about the coefficients. Coefficients can be different, but base and power must be same. So K4, one A part, and it is given that 9x square plus 6y square minus 3x square minus 5y plus 5y square minus 2y. Right? Now, by this, which one are the like terms? We write here like terms equals to base and power, both are same. 9x square and minus 3x square. Second, 6y square and 5y square. Third one, minus 5y and minus 2y. Right? See, in all the base and power is same. So this is the way to find the like terms. Now the B part, that is you can go with this in the book. See, 2x square, this one 2x square, then minus xy, look at the variable xy, this one and this one. Now for 6x and 4x. Now with y, 4y and 3y. See, in this one is vacant, that is minus 4xy cube. So if there is no similar, then no need to write that. Right? So don't write if there is no like term of that number. You have to just find the like terms from the expression. Now come to C part. This is P square. This one P cube. This one. Then P. See, P are, there are 3. And these are the constant. Clear? So no need to write the constant. You have to just write down about the like terms. Clear? This is the like term. Now, the next one is about the degree. Next one is about the degree of the polynomial. So students, what is degree? See, in this question there is two, highest in all. So it means the degree of this polynomial is 2, right? Look, one that is 5x cube plus 3x 4 plus 2x. This is the polynomial given. Now, in this polynomial, the highest degree of the variable is 4. So, the degree of this polynomial is 4. Clear? How to find the degree of the given polynomial or given? Like, in this, the degree of the following term. Here, the power of the x is 1. So, the degree of this term is 1. In this, power of this 2. So, degree of this 2. See, these are the single terms given to you. This is the polynomial, right? So, in the given single term, it is very easy. If it is cube, then degree of this is 3. In this also cube, degree of this term is 3. Clear? Now, come to about the classify the following expression as polynomials and non-polynomials. So, students, as we have discussed earlier, what is polynomials and what are the non-polynomials? So, before that, polynomials can never be in the variables. In the polynomial, variables can never be at the denominator, like these, right? Polynomials are always like this. So it means this a part is non-polynomials and this c part also non-polynomials, and these are polynomials, right? So students, non-polynomials are those whose variables are at denominator, right? Upper value we called numerator and down we called denominators. So clear this one about the numerator and denominator. Now come to key 7, that is classify the following expression as monomials, binomials, trinomials and polynomials. So about this, let us take a recall. That is, see, an algebraic expression with one term is known as monomial, right? In which single terms are there. With two terms, binomial. With three terms, trinomial. And more than three is polynomials. So what we have to do, we have to check the number of terms given in the expression. So look at the first expression, that is 4x plus 3xy. So how many terms are there? 2. So this is binomial, right? Now the b part, 1, 2, 3. How many variables are there in this expression? 3 terms are there. So this is trinomials, right? Now there are 1, 2, 3, 4. More than 3. So this is polynomials. Clear, students? In this also more than 3. So what is this? This is also polynomials. In this 1. So this is monomials. In this 3. So this is trinomials. Clear? Now you understand how to Classify the expressions as monomial, binomials, trinomials and polynomials. Now, after K7, identify the coefficient, variable and constant in the formula for the perimeter of a triangle given by P equals to A plus B plus C. So this one you identify yourself that what is the coefficient, variable and constant. If you're not able to understand, then you will comment and I will discuss this question in the next lecture. After this, this K9, this is also same K8 as it is, so cut it. Now, the K10. In this, what would be the fifth polynomial in the following sequence of the polynomials? So in this, the sequence, the polynomial that is given to you is in the sequence, and that is 2a, 2a plus 3b, 2a plus 3b plus 4c. So by this, students, these are the first, second, third polynomial. We have to find the fourth one, fifth one. Also find the number of terms in the fifth polynomial. So first we will find the fifth one. So see, 2a, firstly with the coefficient 2, 3, 4, then 5, and the fifth one is 6. So 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 and plus 6. Right. Now come to the variable. 1, a, then a plus b, a plus b plus c. For fourth one, a plus b plus c plus d. Now the fifth one, a, b, then c, then 5d and 6e. Right? Clear? If you are facing problem in this direct doing, you will find the fourth one, that is after this 2a plus 3b plus 4c, the next one will be the plus 5d, and after this fourth, next is you have to add the 6e. Clear? After this, find the number of the terms in the fifth polynomial. How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, number of terms, how many? 5 terms. Clear, students? Now, the next question is K11, which is the last question of this. So write a monomial, binomial, trinomial and polynomial each using the variable a. In this question, what you have to do? You have to use one variable that is given here, a. And with the help of this variable, what you have to do? You have to write one example. Monomial, binomial, trinomial and polynomial. This has many answers. Like monomial, only one term. So you can write a also here. Then binomial, 3a square plus 2. You can use constant also. If you want, you can write binomial 2a, two terms, right? Trinomial, you can like this. And polynomial, you can use many. But you have to just use the variable a that is already mentioned here. So this has various answers. Clear, students? So this is about the exercise 11.4, which is about the algebraic expressions. Now after this exercise, we learn how to form an algebraic expression. Means formation of an algebraic expression. In this expression, you can form with the help of addition, subtraction, right? Which we will discuss in the next lecture. So, if anyone have any problem regarding exercise 11.4, you can comment and ask. And before doing this exercise, you have to watch the previous video, which is the introduction of this one.